What's up, everybody? Alright, so I'm Rock. I haven't done a formal review like this on my channel, like, at all before. This is something that's going to be new. I've been getting just tons and tons of requests from personal friends I know, from people that, you know, see me post things on Instagram to do these type of reviews. So this is going to be a shoe review, and I'm going to be reviewing this shoe right here, which is the Crazy Explosive 2016. Now, it seems pretty weird that I'm doing the review on the Crazy Explosive 2016 when the 17 is out now. There's a reason I'm doing this shoe. It's kind of two big reasons. One is because I was able to get my hands on it thanks to Tim at Sports Racket. If you live in Scotts Bluff and you want good shoes and you're an Adidas fan and you just want some crazy basketball shoes or running shoes, UltraBoost, Pure Boost, anything like that, go to Sports Racket. It's right next to Bridal Affairs. He will hook you up. If you want to tell him I sent you down there, I know he would appreciate as much people to come down there as possible. He's the greatest guy, one of the greatest people I've met in this town. So to show him some love, go ahead and head down there, and you can pick yourself up some nice kicks. He's also got Sauconys, New Balance, Reeboks. He's got a good selection down there. He's got clothing. He's got sportswear. He's got basketballs, bags, everything like that. So go ahead and go down there, check him out. Tell them I sent you, and go ahead and hook yourself up with some new gear. Alright, so I'm going to be talking about this shoe. By far, the craziest pair of basketball shoes I have ever played in. Period. I have never had such a responsive shoe before. I'd say the thing that comes closest to it that I'm currently playing now would be the D-Rose 7. And in the past that I've currently played in, I would say would be the D-Rose 5. But there's huge differences such as traction, the boost response, even though this does have a boost up to here. It isn't full length on this one all the way to the toe like this one, the 7, Hardens and everything like that is at all feature boost. But it is, I'd say in terms of comfortability and security on my foot, damn close to the Crazy Explosives. Now, I couldn't even fathom the level of grip this shoe has. This pattern, they kind of have this, it kind of reminds me of the thumbprint, fingerprint pattern on the bottom. The biggest thing that I heard about that was that it frays pretty easily. Surprisingly enough, though, I did not have any fraying after playing for about, I played for about 2.5 hours, and I didn't have any fraying. But this is not 100% not a shoe you can wear on an outdoor court. This is so soft that it will get absolutely destroyed on an outdoor court, mainly here and here on the sole, and it's not going to be worth it. The shoe is too good for you to do that in. Maybe after the shoe is kind of done on the court, you can take it outdoors, but it'll only last you so long. If you've ever worn a shoe with an icy bottom or translucent bottom at all, you will know that most of the time the rubber is pretty soft. Now, granted, all the shoes that I've played with icy bottoms have been really, really, really bad with grip. Adidas has always found a way to get that perfect, even all the way down to the D-Rose 773s. This still has such good grip, and I've had these for about 2.5 years, and I wear them pretty consistently, and it's still got pretty good grip. But this is not that case. This rubber is a little stronger than that one in comparison, but that grip is nowhere near as good as the Crazy Explosive. Now, we could talk about the looks department all we want on this shoe. It is not very pretty. It looks like a boot. It's actually pretty hefty and heavy, but before I tell you that this is an extremely heavy shoe, it feels ridiculously light on your foot, and that's thanks to the full length boost in the shoe. Now, on the lateral side, they have this cage off here for support. It is pretty spongy, and as you can see in some of the clips, it's pretty responsive, but this is pretty spongy. If I squeeze hard enough, you can see it flex. It will bend out and flex to give you that give, but that explosive responsiveness that you need from the shoe. And then on the arch side, it is completely exposed. All of the boost here will give just as much response as the other side would, but this one just kind of gives you that security on this side. Now, I would say this shoe was the Ultra Boost of basketball shoes. And if you've never worn a pair of Ultra Boosts, they are running inspired athletic. I would say they're athletic shoes. because Adidas would say they're athletic shoes, but they are more of a lifestyle shoe now. But anyway, if you haven't had Boost before, you have no clue about the level of comfort, responsiveness, bounce, impact protection, everything that comes from Boost. And I don't want to seem like I am repping Adidas really hard. It is my, they are my favorite company, period. I have their gear. I'm wearing D-Rose hat. He is my favorite player. I even got a pair of socks on right now that's Adidas. But they are not my only company. I also still have a pair of Under Armours that I play in pretty consistently. Recently, I've had another pair of Audi Zeros that I've been playing in, but I usually play in these on outdoor courts. And this type of rubber is 3 times stronger than this outdoor, so I wear this one outdoors. The colorways are very great. I got it when I went to college, and this was college's color. But it's not the best looker, that one, but it's still really good. So I do wear other shoes, but my preferred company is Adidas. That is my first go-to company. If I can't find anything there, then I usually look elsewhere. But I do have one of the first shoes to incorporate Boost into them. This is the RG3. This is right after the Spring Blade released, if you remember that shoe at all, and the hype behind that. Robert Griffin III came out with his shoe. That would be this one that actually had Boost. If you can kind of see it, it says Boost there. But that is this foam-like material that Adidas and other companies, kind of like chemical-based companies, sounds kind of bad saying it that way, but that they all got together and made. And it is the most comfortable material I've ever worn. I've gone from the days of wearing Nike. I've had some... I had the Kyrie 3. This was the replacement of the Kyrie 3. The Kyrie 3, in terms of grip, was amazing. This would come close, but I would say the Kyrie 3 had better grip on an outdoor and indoor court. This has the best on an indoor court, but if I had to give points, it would go to the Kyrie 3. But this shoe is 3 times as comfy, 3 times as responsive, and just... the point of Boost is for energy return, and holy crap, can I say I wasn't even fatigued. I was sweating super hard. I was tired, but my legs and feet were all ready to go, and ready to just keep playing. And RYMCA gets ridiculously hot, so if you can see in the clips, I'm sweating a lot, and it's because they don't have AC, so you can kind of see a fan in the background, but it gets really hot. So that brings me to my next portion of it, ventilation. I'm going to be real with you. It's not that great. It's not to the point where it's uncomfortable or you're like slipping in or anything like that. You might sweat, but you really won't feel it. In the back here, they do have like mesh venting all the way up through here. And then this like little neoprene booty here throughout the entire shoe, because this is not the prime knit edition. It does breathe pretty well, but it is like a form fitting. It feels like another sock, so you will get a lot more sweat. I will say this is drying out, but it's still pretty damp, and I've been home for about 2 hours now. So if I had to pick in terms of, like, you know, breathability, I'd say I would go with my D-Row 7s over these. But this shoe here definitely blew me away in terms of comfort, explosion. I understand why they call them crazy explosives. I even tried the crazy bounce, and those are ridiculous. Bounces... supposed to do the same thing with energy return, but I want to say bounce is kind of like, it uses the same type of Boost material that just wasn't as prominent, or it's a little stiffer than Boost normally is. They've never really officially said anything about bounce other than it does give energy return. If you go look at the crazy explosive or the crazy bounce on Adidas website, it'll give you a full description of what bounce is, but it hasn't been as huge as Boost. Boost is pretty expensive, so that makes the price go up just a little bit more compared to the crazy bounce being only, like, I do believe $130 or something like that. But with this shoe, I will say, in terms of comfort on the foot and staying super gripped on the foot, it was really good. There is flaws with this shoe, I will say. I'm not a fan of the lacing system. It was tight around my foot, but it definitely did come untied a lot more frequently. This would be the same laces as the Oreo Ultra Boost and the D-Row 7s use this type of lace, and it's pretty damn close to the same colorway as well. But I would say this shoe will not help you in terms of durability and also protection. This is still a high top, but this is a pretty flexible high top, as you can see, so that's gonna hurt if you roll your ankle. I say wear an ankle brace if you need to. The GeoFit kind of booty that this shoe uses, as you see here and here, this is an entire inside booty, is good. It fits you directly into your shoe like it needs to, but it still doesn't do much because this is a soft pattern material compared to something like the D-Rose 5 that used a plastic kind of protection material that would also help in terms of ankle rollage. So if you do roll your ankle pretty consistently, I'd say make sure you wear a brace with this shoe. It can definitely fit one comfortably. This is about as far as it can stretch out, and that's pretty big. So another thing that I wasn't a huge fan of is even though it is really, really grippy, it is really, really grippy. So you have to get used to stopping. For me, this is an 11.5, and that is my true shoe size, is 11.5. Most of the time for my basketball shoes, I give it a little more room for my toes to breathe just for that reason. This one fit perfectly, and with it being a booty, I figured that I probably shouldn't go any bigger than that just for sake of security and clutch to, like fit to the foot. But your toe will slide over here if you stop hard enough. You can see when I stop, my foot slides pretty hard. That is just about the case with just about any basketball shoe, but I definitely did feel it a little more. And also here gave a little bit of flex where the rest of the plate here and the shoe is. You can see where it flexes, and this might dig into your ankle once or twice, so it might not be as comfortable as you want it. I do know that it's fixed in the 2017 edition. The 2017 looks pretty dang close to this. It uses most, I do believe it uses all Primeknit, just like the Primeknit edition of the 16. I haven't seen any neoprene versions of the Crazy Explosive 2017, and also they give you kind of a cut here to protect your ankle a little more and give your ankle a little more support on the 2017. So why did I talk about the 2016 in this video? There's one big reason. It is a year old, and it is a year old. That means the shoe shall drop in price. You can most likely find this shoe for $79 to $89, and this shoe was $150. This edition was only $130 because it uses the neoprene. It's not full knit, but this shoe is cheap. And this, if you go and research it online on YouTube, on the reviews, they will tell you is the best basketball shoe that they've played in. They have pretty good contenders like the Kyrie 3, the KD9, all that good jazz, the KD10 now. All of those shoes are really good contenders, but this shoe has always come out on top, so I gave it a shot. It is by far my most favorite basketball shoe. I am going to play in this shoe literally whenever I get the chance to play on an indoor court. Like, I have my 7s. I have my 5s. I have a few indoor shoes that I can use, but I am playing in this one. I've never really had that much energy in terms of like just explosiveness and everything like that, except for with the Rose 5 and the Rose 7. I do like, but it is a little more flat than I would like. This shoe definitely has a little more curve, and on the arch support here is definitely a lot more lateral, I'd say. It gives me a lot more burst. I would say Rose is more of a flat-footed person, so that's why his even has the extra wing on the side here. The grip on the shoe is by far amazing. It rolls up all the way up to here, throughout here, throughout the entire shoe. This is all gripped, so you do have that grip all the way up there as well, except for on this side, which you should never be on that side of the shoe anyway. So they thought that through. On the Prime Knit version, they do have extra supported knit throughout the toe box here. So you don't get any, you know, toe pains here, rolling, doing any point guard moves or anything like that. So, yeah, in terms of shoes, this is by far my most favorite pair of shoes that I have. I'm also going to do a review on the Oreo Ultra Boost. That will be coming when I get into the new place where I can actually use the computer, the mic, everything like that. This was just kind of shot on my phone with the phone's mic, so it doesn't sound very great, but we'll have better cameras, better setup, everything like that over there. And then I do believe the next shoe I want to talk about would be the RG3, just because I don't know if he is any longer with Adidas, but he hasn't released a shoe in like 3 years now, so it's been a little bit. But if you haven't gotten the chance to check these out, I will leave a link in the description to Adidas website so you can check these out. It's going to be kind of hard to find the 16, but you'll see a lot of the 17 right now. But I will leave a direct link to the 16 that so you can find it and check that out. The price should be pretty good on it. If not, they still have their 50% off sale going on right now. So if you want a pair of lifestyle shoes such as the two-wheelers, NMDs, EQT support, anything like that, you can pick them up on their site for cheaper than you can usually find them in a retail store. So I want to say thanks for watching, guys. To everyone that suggested me to do reviews like that, I'm more than happy to. So I know the Oreo Ultra Boost was talked about. It's just some things that people don't talk about. It's like fitment on the foot, how it feels on the foot, everything like that. If you should go true to size or go bigger, I'm going to get a pair of NMDs here soon. Hopefully I can find a good pair of NMDs and talk about those as well. And like I said, I still have plenty of shoes. This entire box here to the right of me is filled with shoes right now. So I have plenty of shoes to talk about. So thank you guys for watching. As always, I'm Rock. If you haven't checked out any of the vlogs or any of the tech reviews or anything like that on the channel, go ahead and check them out. Hit the subscribe button. Right next to that would be a bell icon. If you click that, it'll let you know when I upload the next video. I would much appreciate it. If you liked the video, go ahead and give it a like. I'll see you in the next one. Keep it easy. Press start, now I'm inside of the game. Eyes full of rage, voice saying rise from the grave. Pixelated grass, bricks full of power-ups. Hoping one to steal, I hit it to bring a flower up. Running shoes from Sonic, looking for Robotnik. My side piece, Samus, is acting like I'm a novice. My hand-